Good to be here. I think I've played in New York for a long time.
This is a happy crowd.
Most places I haven't played in 7 years, so. Right now, I'm gonna sing this song right now. Actually, I'm not singing it. One of my co-writers from my new album. My new album is titled Jenny Lee. It's coming out, I think, in January. Charlie Burrell, some of my really good friends, and I've been telling him he should be singing for a long time. He finally got a record. I said, you gotta come sing this on my show. He's playing guitar for me. I'm borrowing him for this tour. Give it up for Charlie Burrell.
To the carpet.
storms, my fires. It's not a fire. Sitting on the couch, not missing. Yeah. On the audience, you know, I'd never really like to do that because I don't like going to shows and people play new songs. I'm like, man, I pay for like the songs I want to hear. But since you've been paying, I'm gonna play all kind of new stuff. Like, I might sing another group's new song. This record is it's called So Ready. My record is titled Jimmy Lee. You see on the drummer, the kick drum, it says Jimmy Lee. Jimmy Lee is my older brother. My album is about addiction. A lot of different types of addiction. Drugs addiction, whatever type of addictions you might, you know, deal with. We all have addictions. Some we just don't know that we have addictions. You know, my brother was a heroin addict. He died in my garage. My other brother died off drugs. He shot himself and killed himself because he couldn't stop. He was embarrassed in front of the soul too good to family we got. So he just said, fuck it. Took himself out. And I was 17 when that happened. Although maybe I was maybe like 28 or something. But through it all, I had music. And I just kept, like, you know, playing, making these songs and just dealing with it that way. I just never really talked about it in the press. I just kept pressing on making music. So I wrote this song called So Ready. Now, my brother Jimmy was funny. He was like that dude Gator in that Spike Lee movie, you know what I mean? He was the dude to break in your house and take all your jackets, steal your stepdad's guns, and then take my jacket. And I said, well, why you take my stuff? He said, I don't like this, your stepdad. I'm like, but you took my jacket. He's like, well, I was going to bring it back, but you didn't bring it back. He was that kind, he was a funny dude. But he always would say, man, I'm really trying, you know, I'm ready now, I'm so ready. And you hear that a lot, people say they're so ready. And I know I have an addiction. My addiction is sweets, you know, I like donuts. Every morning I wake up, I want a donut. I'm like, damn, what's wrong? And I start thinking about my brother. I'm like, this is a donut. We kind of had the same addiction, but, you know, I could just look at the coffee shop with the donut right there. Like, nah, maybe next week. But, you know, and I start thinking about that, and I said, you know what? I was writing these records, and it was about addiction. And I saw this couple dancing in Brooklyn to my song, Sky, Can You Feel Me, on Instagram. And it was called Black Girl Magic and Black Boy Magic. And they were dancing the sky outside with, you know, with no shoes on. They were just dancing in the rain, something similar to this. And I was like, I have to make a song that matched those two people. And the guy sort of reminded me of my brother a little bit. He seemed like the whole neighborhood loved him, but he just has some problems. So this song is called So Ready. So you want to clap along? Check it out, all right? Thank you. So ready, so love, so ready before, so ready. show tonight, please stand up. If anybody missed Sadiq show tonight, please stand up. When you make it, my bread bash, you should be in. You need me to feel me, to heal me. You should be in, to wrap me, and then climb me. You should try me, you should be in. I'm a good man, and I work hard on my high child. Let me show you what you're messing with.
I want the change.
Just like you surprised, I'm surprised just like you. So right now I'm gonna take you for a ride in my car, 2 o'clock in the morning. Okay?
Love of my life.
surprised about this one, just come on. I'm like Victoria, you know, secret, you know, don't go. Tomorrow you'll come home, and girl, I can't wait to see an anniversary. And the first thing I'll do is rush back to kiss her anniversary. Anniversary. And all I want to say, all day, today is a special day. grew up trying. Get my cell phone. Smoke it or do whatever you gotta do. Ain't it up? Stayed in prison a whole life. Long story, so when I used to go see Jimmy, I thought he was a celebrity because the whole family would pack up and go see him in prison, you know. So, but then like the third time I noticed that he couldn't leave, and I said, "Let's go, bro." He was like, "I can't go nowhere." And I realized he's not a celebrity, he's in jail. And I was like, wow, I've seen all these numbers on his, you know, his suit and everything. I was like, just crazy. And I noticed all the Mexicans and white people and Asian people, was so many different people just locked up in this prison. I saw the lawyers' cars was like BMWs and all that. And then on the other side, it was just old cars. So I saw how the law was making money off everybody. It was just crazy.
Got it.
You know what I'm saying? Then later on, I started seeing people like Snoop wearing the same outfits that they was wearing on stage. And it looked dope because I like gear. And I was like, it's kind of dope, but that's a jail outfit. But you know, we fresh like that. We make things out of anything. We make it look fresh, right? But it always stuck in my mind how we just want to look like we in prison all the time. So I wrote this song. It's called Rikers Island.